Welcome back, F1 Manager Nation, Manager Legend. Sorry for not hosting in over a week. You know how it goes, family stuff. Okay, so I got my two free crates. Got another free crate. And we got a platinum. So that's nice. Now we're going to upgrade Kubica. Hey, I got Max Verstappen. Okay, let's see what Max has. Very poor tire management. Less than below average consistency, very good defending, pretty good fuel management, and he's a good wet weather driver. With that tire management, he's going to have to pit on soft tires probably about 3 times, if not more, per race, and you can't go with hard tires. I wonder if I could do that. No, not with that overtaking. Yeah, probably not with the overtaking. I don't know, I might give him a shot, see what he got. Okay, so my drivers are Sergio Perez and Lando Norris. I have 900,000. Grosjean's upgrade is going to be 506. I'm sorry, 560. Yeah. Okay, start one of those crates. I save the gold crates for when I'm going to be away for at least 8 hours. Okay. Okay, so once again, it's kind of important that you stick in the same series. You can win as many flags before you move up. That way you're not going to be wagering like half of the money you have. Okay, we are at Brazil. Okay, we got a race on our hands. I can get 4 laps on softs with both of my drivers. Flip this around. Okay, so I can get 4 laps with softs. So we are going to start off on softs. Since it says we can get 4 laps, that means we can probably boost off the line.
So we are in 18th and 21st. You can see how when you go low power, your drivers take a much more conservative line. And as the hints tell you, the more you ask your drivers to push, the more likely they are to make a mistake. So all the other cars will start coming into pit. And it looks like we may have enough fuel to actually sprint the fourth lap. Stop soft, please stop soft. We are going to have a bit of a stacking issue. Oh shoot, I forgot that these guys take 5 seconds. Ah! Oh man, I'm butchering this. I haven't played this account in almost a week and a half. Well, about 2 weeks almost. Kvyat ran out of tires. Oh, Perez makes a huge mistake, costing us the win. Oh man, it was horrible. Okay, now I remember. It was a very expensive lesson I just learned. Okay, let's give this another shot. And I remember it takes them 5.5 seconds for a pit stop. Okay. Okay, let's see what we get. She has a very sizable lead on this. Okay, Grosjean is gonna have to pit next lap. Sorry, rival Grosjean. You can see Lewis Hamilton is gonna have to pit after lap 3. So that already equals about a quarter of the lap that we're going to make up. We're going with Grosjean. Grosjean is in. Grosjean should be moving. There we go. Drivers are 2 seconds apart, so you gotta go. Oh wait, I'm only on lap 3, how am I doing?
Did you turn that off?
No, it starts itself.
Should I turn it off?
Yeah. Sorry. Okay, so I'm gonna have Perez go around another lap. Hopefully Norris will be able to catch up. I don't see how he's gonna catch up, seeing how he's in dead last, about to be lapped. Ugh. I'm supposed to try and get a one stop to watch Perez, except for that one fact that he just lost all that time because of a broken component.
Okay, looks like we got ourselves a little race here. The race is for both of my drivers to catch Hamilton. Also gaining finishing behind Grosjean with a car between Norris and Hamilton. So he's going to finish in sixth. Can we catch? No. Nope, almost. Nope. That broken component cost us the win. So I figured out what I was doing wrong. I am using a strategy that I use with my other account because I've been playing that account and haven't been playing this one. So I gotta go back to trying to get a one-stop strategy. Cost me 400,000 coins to remember that. That's all right. Sergio Perez. Fuel management, okay, I can't upgrade them yet. I have to win a race. Okay, let's see how we qualify. Okay. Awesome. 3-4, 3-4. Stop strategy for both of my drivers. so that here's what we got going on. So my rival is racing to keep up. So we should be about 3 second gap and 2.5. And my lead car suffering from the broken component. So we're gonna keep him out. Okay. So we're going to sprint the second half of the race. Oh, with Norris. Perez is going to go another lap before he pits. Okay. Okay, so as you can see, the key is to use as few pit stops as possible. Okay, that's a little bit better. I thought I was losing my mind there for a second. I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on? Alright, I'm changing the water in one of my aquariums, so I gotta go, and we'll be right back. Okay, we are at Sochi. Once again, we're going to try to do a one stop more than trying to finish the final four laps on soft. Okay, I apologize for the lag. Looks like we're using up about 20% of our tires per lap. And just because you have a broken component doesn't mean you have to pit. Just, you know, the drivers always say that, but as you can see, he's still competitive to the drivers around him on the grid. So there's really no need to bring him in early. So I think we're going to have about two more laps. Before we're gonna have to come in again. Everybody else is putting on wet, and it's going to stop raining right now. Okay. Hopefully we got a 5 second gap between our drivers, which we do. We should be like the only drivers out on the
appropriate tires. And the computer's algorithm is telling their drivers to stay out because their tires are good. Perez is up into the top 10. All the drivers should be coming in. Not all of them, a fair number of them. Anybody who stayed out is either going to have to come in or they are not going to win the race. Well, we're not going to win it either way. There's a Raikkonen out front. Where can he go? And Perez catch him. Good job, Norris. Good Lando go. Second and fourth, I'll take that. The two-stop strategy worked. Only because of the rain. So because of the rain, a lot of drivers got stuck out on the bad strategy, so I was able to make up so much space. I'm sorry, some of these places. And try to reset the app. Hopefully I can get rid of some of that lag. Okay. Let's see if we got rid of the lag. Okay. I want to go one-stop strategy. It's not going to rain. So we're going to go hard for 5 laps, and then soft for 3. so we are off on hards. It looks like a bunch of other drivers around us have hards. So Hamilton should go out to a lead, but he's gonna have to pit after. Hamilton's gonna have to pit at the end of this lap. Oh, he stayed out. Well, we will see. Hamilton in the pits, and what tires is he putting on? Hards. So he's going to try to go to the end on hards. So we're starting lap 4, and we still have, what, 60% of our tires left? So I could go, no I can't, coming up on the end of lap 4. So this is going to be a halfway point with 45% left. So you can race. I'm going to come in for soft tires and sprint to the end. And you can do the same thing. Okay. Okay, so both of my drivers are good to the end of the race. Definitely on fuel and definitely on tires. Way off track, costing dearly, and he's going to be stuck in 8th place because of that. Hey, Norris got first, good job. So you guys saw how the one-stop strategy works.
And that's what happens when you stop playing a game for 2 weeks. Losing races because of broken parts, so I'm okay with my reliability for now. Extra bit of grit. It probably equals 0.05 of a second per lap. Right. Okay. Probably go Perez and Giovinazzi. Giovinazzi will finish the races a lot better. He has good tire management. I'm going to rock with Lando Norris for now. Okay, I'm gonna get one more. I'm gonna get one more race crate. I'm gonna get one more race crate. Open up the race crate. Start downloading this video to YouTube and go to bed. It's 2 in the morning of my time.
Mexico, so it's kind of a short track, if I remember correct. Okay. Only 13% of tire wear on horns. Okay, as I was hoping, there's a organic gap opening up between our drivers. It is about 3.5 seconds. So we're on lap 4. There's so much time, Jeff, that's the loss, but I'm going to let his tires go bald. Sprint. I'm not coming for soft tires. Okay. They've given me 5 laps, and the softs are going to give me 3. The race with my rival is pretty much over, as he's going to have to come in and pit again, both cars. So he's trying to hold out with Giovinazzi, but he just now realized it's not going to make a difference, so he's probably racing with him. Nope. No, he's going to keep Giovinazzi out. And that's a good example of you have to somehow manage both of your drivers. You can't focus on one and have the other one finish dead last. That's not going to do anything for you. All right, two more races, and we got a crate to open. Oops. Okay. A crappy standard crate. So if you've been playing this game, you've been having a hard time. Winning consistently, and you can see how you can run out of coins and also get dropped out of divisions and stuff for not making enough. Especially if you're stuck racing the lower tier races because you just don't win enough. But by the time you get to this point, you should start putting in a fair amount. Okay. All right, hearts, we're going to use you until it rains. Okay. So we're gonna have this lap and the next one before we have to come in. If he's smart, he'll keep Gasly out. So you can see it's a light rain. Light rain, so it's taking a little bit longer to for the track to get wet, so it's not going to get 100% wet. Track just got 100% wet. Why didn't you go in? I thought I had you set to go in. Oh well. Hey, Perez, if you can hold them off. I don't think you're going to be able to. Your tires are going to go off the edge right about now. If you get 21st, 20th and 21st, got it. Wow, even though I messed up twice. Okay, that didn't really help my race crate total. So that's gonna add another race. So Tempre Flamingo. Well, it looks like we have a race. Looks like Williams right now, driving back. You can see the difference in tire wear. So he is probably not running full power. It's probably medium power. But again, anything you're doing at the beginning of the race, when all the drivers are kind of on the same level of consistency and tire wear and all of that, especially if you're on hards, you're kind of working against yourself, because if you could go low power and save all that power for when you have traction with soft tires, you'll make up a lot more ground. Right now I need Perez to open that gap up. About 5 seconds, which is what it is. Soft tires. So I'm going to have Perez cruise through that section. And should be just about caught up on fuel, hopefully. So hopefully Perez can go to the end. I know Norris can, so I'm not worried about that. See how at the end of the race you got guys with broken components, dudes on hard compound, guys with tires that are almost completely worn. So Whoever's in first place just crossed the line. And you can see his Norris keeps having to let off of full power. Okay, if I can get a good draw, I can win enough. Well, I can get more than 40 points. Some races I do. Yeah, that should be interesting. I think I have any flags. Okay. Well, you just saw the last race, if you were watching, so now I'm going to do it again. Yeah, I'm going and then backing down. Oops. You can see Perez is back there blocking. So he's just keeping everybody behind him back there. That's what your blocking stat does. He's on soft tires and he's on medium power. He finally passed me just in time to go into the pits. 2.5 seconds. Okay, so both my drivers are ahead of his driver, respectively. And now with only 2 laps to go, both my drivers have enough tires and fuel. And Perez is 12 and 12. Okay, well, I need 6 points. And I can get my crate and go to bed. Alright, guys. I really like these races. Especially that one. If I could guarantee I could play that one, I would do it. But I like that one, too. Circuit of the Americas. You know, let's give this one a shot and see what we get. Where are we going? Yes, Circuit of the Americas. Okay. So I'm going to try and one stop. So Norris was in dead last. He's slowly making up the ground that he lost in the first turn, most likely. Perez is up ahead leading that little bunch. I should say bunching that group up, which is good because now Norris isn't that far back. Is that Red Bull coming out of the pits already? Yeah, Toro Rosso, sorry. So you see, just by staying out, we're getting positions. Now starting the fourth lap. There's an organic enough gap that I don't have to worry about my drivers. So as soon as they finish lap four, they're going to sprint one lap. Actually, so both my drivers can sprint four laps and conserve four laps. Conserve just a little bit here, so on the curvy sections. the 15th. And that's with the broken component. Okay, here's a race crate. Sorry if I wasn't going too much talking. I'm a little bit on the tired side. But anyway, you guys got to see the beginning of the video, me struggle with poor strategy and then figure out that I needed to limit my pit stops to as few as possible. Upgrade Perez. All right. All right, guys, this is F1 Manager Legend signing out. Please like, subscribe, and leave any comments, questions, concerns. If you do check, you'll notice that I do answer all the comments. And the ones I don't answer, I definitely appreciate. Hopefully these videos are helping you learn how to do a little bit better at these games. Or I should say at this game. So that if you are an F1 fan, you can enjoy this game, because I think it is a pretty fun game, especially once you get the gist of it and get the hang of it. I'm sorry, I'm looking at the my car and all of the little parts added on. I wonder if it changes as you go through the game. I'm not sure. Anyway, signing out. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I will talk to you later.